Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm showcasing the Spellbinders card kit. This is the card kit of the month June. It is a subscription box and it costs only $35, which is a great price for all the goodies that are included. In the June card kit, you will get this leaflet with a list of all the products included, and at the back you will find some inspiration on how to get started and make a card. Let's start with the paper pad. This is 6x6 and it includes lovely designs in beautiful pastel colors. You get two pages of each design, and some of the designs are actually foiled, so you get lovely specialty paper. Now this is a bag of die-cut shapes. There are about 100 of them, if I'm not mistaken. There are beautiful designs in lovely pastel colors. Again, they match perfectly with the colors of the paper pad. In some of the cutouts, you can pop out the inside pieces for a different look. And all in all, I think they are really gorgeous and they are great for creating quick and easy cards, which is exactly what I'm going for today. So you can see here the beautiful selection. And I don't know if you can tell, but you get two times each design. The kit also comes with a stamp set with lovely sentiments and lots of designs that you can use on your cards. You also get 6 journaling cards. These are all double-sided. You can see all the designs here as I browse through them. And of course you can use these as little panels to stick on top your focal points when it comes to card making. You get double-sided tape and foam adhesive. In the same color combo, you get these stickers. It includes sentiments as well as designs for your projects. And let's take a look at the dies now. They are not joking about adding dies in these kits, because you always get lots for your money. With these dies, you can create a dog balloon, you can create candles, birthday candles, and this heart can be used separately or in conjunction with these other dies to create sunglasses. I'm going to show you an example in one of the inspirational cards that I include in this video. And finally, you get two dies that cut out "Oh Joy". Now, just like always, you get 10 envelopes in white, as well as 10 pre-folded cards. Now in this month you will also get 2 vellums. These are quite transparent and they have this lovely foiling on top. One of them has lots of words and the other one has tiny little bows, really cute one. You'll also get this tiny little jar with sequins in a lovely color that matches perfectly all the foiling in those pieces. And finally, let's take a look at the cardstock. There are 6 pieces of cardstock included. All of them match perfectly the color combo of the kit. Now, the first 5 cards that I'm going to share today are really quick and simple. I just want to show you how easy it is to put things together and make really stunning cards in no time with this kit. And then I'm going to make a more complicated one, which is not really that difficult. So for the first card, I'm using this lovely paper. I'm going to add some glue at the back and stick it on top. The paper is slightly smaller than my card base, so I end up having a white border all around, which is something that I always like to have on my cards. Now I'm going to combine some of the cutouts, and I'm trying to play around. I play around here trying to decide where I want everything to go. Once I'm happy with the placement, I will go ahead and add some foam tape on some of the elements and stick everything down. Notice that my sentiment goes outside of the card, and I did that deliberately. I think that it gives more interest to the card, and of course I will use my scissors to cut off the excess. And it may be quite noisy as I'm doing this voiceover because I have all my windows open. It's really warm here in Greece these days. Summer is already here. It's 31 degrees, which is about 87 for my American friends in Fahrenheit. And by the way, I'm calling this card done. It was super easy to put together. It looks really fresh and fun, and it was so easy to create. You can see here some close-up photos on this card, and I'm going to move on and make a second one, again super simple to create. I'm going to use all those dies that create the dog balloon, cut them out from the pink cardstock, and then I'm going to put everything together. And notice here I'm adding some details before removing the piece from the die. I'm adding some white chalk ink, and you will see that this is going to add a lovely detail. It's going to look as if it is highlighted. By placing all those little pieces with foam tape on top of the main body, you will see that this gets really dimensional, and it is a great focal point for any of your cards. And you can recreate it with any color that you like, or even with pattern paper. Now, since the weather is getting warmer and the kids are out of school, I will be spending most of my days with them at the beach swimming. So for June and July, I will be taking things slowly. I won't be posting as regularly, and I will be completely missing in action during August, where we usually visit the Greek islands. Okay, back to the card, and I have my little balloon ready to go. Now I'm cutting out this pattern paper, and all those dots are foiled. Again, this paper is smaller than the standard card to get that white border that I always like to have. And I'm making sure that I have the pink area towards the bottom, so that when I stick the balloon on top, it's going to have some contrast with the blue at the back. For the sentiment, I went with one that says Happy Birthday, one of the cutouts from the kit, and I'm going to call this card done. Really fun, really beautiful, and super quick to create again. And here are some close-up photos. For my next card, I have picked those two white butterflies from the cutouts, and I'm using two rectangle dies, one inside the other, to create a very thin frame, and I'm using that golden cardstock from the card kit. I also used the larger of those rectangle dies to cut out this pattern paper. I'm adding white glue at the very edge of this panel, and then at the top I'm going to stick the frame, the golden frame, that I have cut out. This creates a gorgeous panel. I love pink and gold together, where I can stick my sentiment and my focal point. The sentiment is one of the die-cut banners that says you are the best and the mostest, and it has a lovely fold detail. And as the focal point, I'm going to stick one butterfly on top of the other, only at the center, so I will be able to add some dimension by lifting the top wings like so. I'm going to add some glue at the back of my butterfly, and I'm going to stick it down, making sure that I only stick the bottom butterfly while the other one can have some movement. Now this panel is going directly on top of one of the pre-folded cards from the kit, and I'm going to call this done. You can embellish it a little bit more if you want by adding some of the golden sequins. And also in the kit you get another butterfly in pink color similar to this one, so you can recreate the look with different colors. For the next card, I picked this beautiful pattern paper with the foiling. It has a lovely geometric design. I cut it out to be smaller than my card base. I'm going to stick that there. And it doesn't get easier than that. I'm going to stick down the balloons, as well as a couple of the cutouts that have sentiment on top, and I combine the one that says gorgeous with another one that says hello, which I'm going to stick one on top of the other. And I will finish off my card by adding some of those golden sequins. I could create tons of cards just by using only the 100 die cuts included in this kit, and there are so many different ways to put things together and create different focal points, and you end up with really gorgeous cards. They look very professional and they took no time at all. For my next card, I'm using one of my rectangle frames to cut out a panel out of this gorgeous pattern paper. I'm sticking this down on top of one of the pre-folded card bases, and then I picked from the cutouts lots and lots of candles, birthday candles, so that I can make a birthday card. Now, of course, there is a die to cut out candles, so you can go to town with those. You can create different sizes, you can use different colored cardstock or pattern paper. I'm just going the easy way, just because I told you I will be using lots of those die cuts to show you different ideas on how to create easy cards. One way to arrange them is to put all the candles randomly, one close to another, or you can completely lay everything nicely and neatly in a row. The same idea, you can create a different looking card just by changing the background paper or arranging the candles in a different way. I'm going to use the foam squares at the back of this banner that says Happy Birthday. I'm going to stick that over the candles and I'm calling this card done. And that was another super quick card. Seriously, it takes less than 5 minutes to make this. It only takes a lot of time to pick up all those little candles from the bunch of the cutouts. Now, for the next card, I'm going for something more complicated. Here I used the dies to cut out all those pieces that create the glasses. I cut them out from the pink cardstock from the kit, and now you can see that I'm connecting everything together. At the back of the glasses, I'm going with white glue around the hearts, and then on top I'm going to stick some acetate. This is just some thin acetate from packaging. You can even use those iridescent foils and cut out a heart to stick it inside for an inlay look. It would look fabulous as well. You can even create a shaker card where you have sequins inside those hearts moving up and down on those glasses. There are so many different ways to use these dies. I am going to show you the simple way so you can see how you can put the glasses together. And here I'm working at the back of the glasses, added some glue, and I'm going to stick the last pieces to complete my glasses. Now I'm using the grid on my mat to make sure that everything is nicely aligned. And my focal point is ready to go. This is where I decided that I wanted to add some more sparkle on my glasses. That's why I'm going all around the front and I'm going to stick on top those golden hearts that I have cut out. For my sentiment on this card, I went with a couple of the die cuts from the kit, one that says spectacular and a tiny one that says you are. And I used a foam square to stick down the glasses so that I end up having some dimension there. Now to finish off the card, and since it's all about spectacular, I'm going to add a few of the golden sequins, which come together nicely with the golden frame on my glasses. And now that you have the main parts to create glasses, you can use different dies that you have on your stars and be really creative. For example, instead of hearts, you can use stars or even circles. And now let's take a quick look on all of the cards that I made using the Spellbinders Card Kit of the Month. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget, just like always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using down below in the description area. Don't forget to like and comment, and also subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you so much for spending some time with me today, and I'll see you all next time.